birds and know that I'm a vegan. I ain't eating no beef, no pork, no fish, no chicken. Now people think I'm tripping cause I ain't eating no dairy, no eggs. But I stay well fed off the fruits and the veg cause I care about the animals and the environment. I care about my health. If it ain't vegan, I ain't buying it. I care about the planet. If it dies, then we gon' die with it. People hating veganism without even trying it.
Alright everyone, today we're going to do a bit of a taste test. We've got this vegan bacon. I was sent this vegan bacon by a vegan cartel. We've heard good reports about this stuff, so we're going to cook it up and do a taste test. Wow, I've just opened the packet. It smells really nice. Okay, what we're going to do is lay it out on this sheet here, baking sheet. Boom. Alright guys, I've got a grill here. We're going to chuck it under the grill. Really smells delicious while it's cooking. You're just going to keep an eye on it when you grill stuff. Looks really good. Smells amazing too. Alright, let's try. Oh my. It's really, really good. Good stuff. Here you go guys, you can even chuck it in the pan and fry it up like this. Alright, taste test. Oh my god. One thing I've noticed, if you really want to get the best out of this bacon, in the fry pan, little bit of oil. When it's done, pat the oil off with a paper towel. And that is, oh my god, that is amazing. Be careful not to overcook it. Still want it a bit chewy, but crispy. Oh, you gotta try it. All right, so we've got a couple of buns here. All right, so what we're doing is a traditional bacon butty. I think that's how you pronounce it, butty. They have them here in England. All right, this is my favorite cheese. We're gonna put some of this on. Add on your vegan cartel bacon. Look at that. There we go. Boom. All right, there it is. Check it out. This is a British, this is like native British food, but vegan style. Let's do a taste test. Wow. Wow. One more. Oh my God. One thing they've got right is the texture and the flavor is amazing. It doesn't, I was gonna put yours truly, but it doesn't actually need it. Delicious. We'll put some anyway. Oh, yum. All right, so there you have it. The vegan bacon, the famous vegan bacon from the vegan cartel. Really delicious. You could make scrambled tofu with this stuff. You could add this anywhere a recipe calls for the corpse of a pig. You can replace it with this. Now, you might not like these vegan bacons and vegan mock meats. That's fine. Buy them, support them, and give them to your friends. Give them to your non-vegan friends. It's an excellent form of activism. You're giving them alternatives. You're replacing the foods that they love with more ethical choices. Amazing. We all know how pigs are raised and killed. They're used, exploited, suffer in gas chambers, horrific factory farms. Even free-range pigs are all going to get a knife in their throat. Horrible for these intelligent beings. Vegan bacon's a better choice. Better for you, better for the animals, better for the environment. Try it out. First off, you just chuck some onions in. Boom. We want to get these brown. Just got a bit of tofu. That was just what was left in the fridge. Boom. All right, so we've got a bit of curry powder to chuck that in. This is just some sweet potato and some cauliflower. Chuck it in. All right, we've got some of this Rogan Joss. Vegan, chuck it in. Give it a bit of a rinse out with some water. Boom. All right, we've got a can of chickpeas. Chuck them in. All right, with your coriander, just chop the stalks nice and fine, and then as you get closer to the leaves, chop them bigger and bigger. We'll put the stalks in first because they take longer to cook. Boom. Get that all cooking down. All right, let's chuck in a bit of boiling water. chuck in a bit of my favorite ingredient, peas.
Whoa.
All right, get a lid on. Boom. All right, so there's many ways to do this, but I'm just gonna do it as quickly and easily as possible. No one's really got like 2 hours to spend in the kitchen. Just boom, boom, get it in, make it taste good and easy. Here you go, secret ingredient. Add in a little bit of veggie stock to everything. It makes it taste good. So we're gonna chuck in a little bit of coconut milk. Just a splash. All right, now over here, I've got a bit of a surprise. I was chucked an eggplant on top of the hob there with the gas, and I watched my friend Case and his dad make this dip with an eggplant. So what you do is you just chuck it on the hob and get it burnt and roasted. You could probably do it on a barbecue or something. And then, you know, I chucked it in this bowl and I've let it steam, and I'm gonna take off the black skin. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take off all the burnt skin. Nice charred eggplant. I'll show you what this is gonna be. Okay, so here it is with the skin removed. I'm just gonna dice it up into some pieces, straight into this bowl. It might not look appetizing just yet, but trust me. All right, the first and most important ingredient is this tahini. Let's just hit it some of that, boom. Hit it up. That's it. That's the stuff. That's what makes it taste excellent. Second ingredient, a lemon. Squeeze that in. Oh my. The next, I'm gonna put a pinch of coriander in there, just a pinch. Excellent. This is just a rolling pin, and it's got a bit of protection on the end of it just because I didn't want to get the rolling pin dirty. And let's go. Let's hit it up. You go, put a little bit of garlic in there. Boom. Keep going. All right, needs some salt. It definitely needs some salt, so hit it up with some. Pepper as well, put some pepper in there. Now let's do the taste test. That is amazing. All right, now let's get the rest of the coriander in. It's nearly done. It's thickened up quite well. Give it a stir around, look at that. Little squeeze of lemon juice, just a bit. Okay, so in the oven here, we've had some broccoli and cauliflowers baking away, so they're nice and roasted. They will go with the eggplant dip. All right, now check out how thick and fragrant that is. Really good. Chuck it on next to your rice. Wow. So here it is. Served with a poppadom on the side. Amazing. Easy, quick, delicious. And check out the dip. Beautiful. All right, so there you go. A quick, easy curry recipe and a nice Mediterranean dip recipe. Thanks, Jeff and Case, for that one. And you got to try these. Stay cruelty-free, stay vegan. Look at that. How easy is it? Do it. Whoa, I nearly forgot the secret ingredient. Mango chutney, let's go. Ah, oh, guess where it's going? Straight on top. About that, mate. Yummy?
Gotta make a change. It's time for us as a people to start making some changes. Let's change the way we eat, let's change the way we live, and let's change the way we treat each other. You see, the old way wasn't working, so it's on us to do what we gotta do to survive. And still, I see no changes.